Hey, this is Joel from Kinovea. Welcome to the overview of the changes for version 0.8.21. So there has been many changes since the last experimental version, and I figured out it would be easier to show them instead of trying to describe them in the forum post. So this is not a tutorial. I will just try to give a quick highlight of the latest changes. First, Kinovea now supports Catalan and Serbian locales. So we go to Options, Language, and there you can see Catala and Serbski. Let's do a bit on the File Explorer. Some efforts have been made to improve the keyboard navigation. It is better synchronized with the file list here. And some classic keyboard shortcuts have been implemented. For example, hitting F5 will refresh the list in case you have changed the files through Windows Explorer. And the Control Add and Control Subtract will change the size of the thumbnails. Regarding keyboard shortcuts, you can now review them and customize them. For that, we go to Options, Preferences, and here you choose the keyboard panel. Here you will see the list of shortcuts by categories of the user interface. Hopefully the interface to customize shortcuts is not too complicated, so I'm not going to spend much more time on this. Back to the main screen, the player now supports SVG files as first class files. And as for other type of images, when you open one, it will turn into a 10-second video. As you can see, this can be quite useful for field diagrams. And as they are SVGs, they will scale up and scale down without losing quality. In the Explorer, in the File Explorer, the file list is now scrolling vertically instead of horizontally. And keyboard shortcuts also have been implemented here. When you open a video from the Windows Explorer or from File Open, a temporary shortcut will be added here. What is interesting about this is that when you close the video, you will land in the directory of the video. So this could be interesting to quickly jump to another video from the same directory. But probably the most interesting change in the Explorer panel is the new camera tab. Here you will see a list of thumbnails of your currently plugged in cameras. They are not live thumbnails, but if you plug camera in, it should appear in a few seconds, about four or five seconds. And you can always hit F5 to refresh the view. You can create an alias for cameras by right-clicking the thumbnail and choosing rename. Here, for example, I will rename this to my DV camera. And you can also change the icon from a set of predefined icons. So this looks better. To configure a network camera, you use the manual connection. This will display the same settings as were before inside the camera, the capture screen. So you can configure how Kinovea should connect to the camera. Remember that only for now, only MJPEG and JPEG streams are supported. So I will open the capture screen. Here you can see the view from my apartment. The whole capture screen, it's moving. The whole capture screen have been rewritten from scratch, so please report any problem, any issues, if you find some. The viewport here has also been rewritten, and it will be used in future versions for the player screen. So it's especially important that even if you don't use the camera screen, that you try it and see if you can find problems or anything and report them. So let's take a quick tour of this new viewport. Most important thing, the image container can be moved around and resized. And this specific camera will remember where we placed the image and at which size. So when you reopen the camera, it will be at the same place and the same size. Also, very important addition is the drawings can now expand outside the image container. And if you resize or move the image, the drawings will follow. The zoom feature also has been improved. It's simplified, so now it will directly expand the view. And the zoom itself is exponential, so it is more natural. Here I'm using control and mouse wheel to zoom in and out. The top bar here will have informations about the video, the current configuration of the video, and the actual image size and frame rate at which Kinovea is receiving images. Note that the delay slider is also exponential, so you have better precision in the smaller range and less precision in the larger ranges. I will switch to a two capture screen workspace, and you can see the common controls finally for the capture, so you can simultaneously launch operations like snapshot or record. And note that you can also drag cameras from the file, from the camera list, to the capture screens. Okay, let's move to player screen. So remember that the viewport we just saw in the capture screen is not yet implemented in the player screen. This will be for a future version. One of the new features I really like is the pagination. It's quite simple. Basically, the videos can be navigated with the page down and page up keys. What it does is when you hit page down, it jumps to the next 10-person spot in the video. It's like the video is a 10-page book. And if you do shift page down, it just jumps to the next 1%. So this should be interesting to quickly scan a long training session or a match. Another new interesting thing is the ability to copy the current image to the clipboard. So you right-click the image and you have copy image to clipboard. Then you can paste it in another document. The other changes are related to the custom tools, so I will open my blank file here so it's easier to see. There are two new tools called Human Model . So they basically behave as you would expect. The small circle here is the center of gravity. It is computed in real time using the positions of the other segments and weights coefficients. You can also right-click the tool and have it display the actual coordinates of the center of mass. If I had proper calibration here, it would display this in the proper units. And what is also interesting about these tools is that all the features implemented to create these tools are now available for your own custom tools. So that is displaying a point coordinates, having segments with specific colors, the concept of computed points where a point position is dependent on the position of other points, and the concept of optional content where a right-click menu entry is automatically created to enable or disable some content. So that's it for the video. Thanks for watching. The link to the installer will be in the video description. And again, do not hesitate to report any problem you might have or ideas for future versions. Bye-bye.